Week's top stories. We begin in Libya, where rebels are advancing west towards the capital, Tripoli, after regaining control of a strategic eastern oil town from pro-Gaddafi forces. Meanwhile, NATO ambassadors are due to meet later on Sunday to discuss the transfer of control of the mission in Libya from the coalition. RT's Paul Osler is in the capital for us and joins us now live. Paul, the rebels are reporting significant gains this weekend. What's been happening in Libya overnight?
Well, there certainly does seem to be a turnaround on the ground. In the town of Ajdabiya, which is 160 kilometers away from Benghazi, Benghazi, of course, being the rebel stronghold, there we know that the opposition fighters are back in the town and have taken over. And they're now beginning a march towards the town of Bega, which is another 70 kilometers westwards. But we haven't as of yet received any confirmation that the fighters have actually taken over the town of Bega. Overnight, in the last 24 hours, the air campaign destroyed at least 5 Libyan planes and 2 helicopters. Now, as you can imagine, the mood in Ajdabiya is one of celebration, but we are hearing some concerns from some of the residents there. They say that they are fearful that the fighting will return, and also that some of them are distrustful of the rebel fighters themselves. The focus on the rebel groups now is an advancement westwards, and this brings with it a whole host of questions. Gaddafi's forces are along the road, so just how will they be able to overcome those fighters? We are expecting that there will be much further heavy resistance to the rebel fighters, so the euphoria that they're experiencing at the moment might be very short-lived. There was also fighting in the city of Misrata. This is the closest city to the capital, Tripoli, in terms of where the rebels and Gaddafi soldiers are coming face-to-face. Misrata is about a two-hour drive from here, and there we are actually hearing that the government has the upper hand and that they've brought in reinforcements and they've started reshelling the town.
Paula, it's been over a week now since the coalition began enforcing the no-fly zone over Libya. How has the course of action changed during this time and, of course, affecting the Libyan people?
Well, you need to remember that the coalition airstrikes are there ostensibly to protect civilians. But it took them more than a week for the rebels to actually overcome the might of Gaddafi's army. So this does confirm how reliant your opposition fighters are on international involvement. They have actually called to the international community to conduct more airstrikes. They admit that there was a relatively limited defense that they came up against in Ajdabiya. So the question being asked is just how can they make good on their claims to march all the way to Tripoli? And it begs the question, just how far will the Western alliances go in terms of providing air cover and protecting the opposition fighters? Now, the government here in Tripoli has actually accused the Western community of taking sides in this fight. To quote the government spokesperson, Ibrahim Musa, he said that this is immoral, it's illegal, and it is action that was not authorized by the UN Security Council. He says that the coalition forces say that they are there to protect civilians, but actually they're pushing the country to the brink of civil war. Now, what is also confusing at this stage, and we certainly don't have any independent verification of it, is how far back Gaddafi's forces have indeed been pushed. Certainly in the eastern part of the country, it does seem as if the rebels for now are winning, but just how much firepower Gaddafi's men have to retaliate is a question that no one as of yet can answer.
NATO is gearing up to take over the operation. What are Libyans expected from this switch?
Well, NATO today is expected to take command of the no-fly zone. They're also meeting to discuss whether or not they will take control of the whole operation. This has been called the no-fly plus. And we're hearing from officials that they're likely to give their nod to this. In fact, we're hearing from the United States that there are just a few more steps in the planning process, and after this, control and command of the whole mission will firmly be in the hands of NATO members. The sticking point, and this is the point that Libyans themselves are focused on, is just what kind of role the NATO alliances will play in terms of protecting civilians on the ground. If you have a scenario, for example, that Gaddafi's forces are out in the desert where there are no civilians and they're taking a stand there. Just what kind of role will NATO play in that particular scenario? Another scenario that's being put forward is that your rebels are now planning an advancement over towns that are firmly in Gaddafi's hands, towns where there never was fighting before. Now, this is clearly an offensive. Are the NATO alliances going to continue to provide air power and coverage as they advance westwards more and more to Tripoli? Increasingly, the feeling on the ground is that you're going to have a stalemate position, that this country is going to be divided. And in most quarters here, whether you are a Gaddafi supporter or a rebel supporter, most people actually do not welcome that kind of a scenario.
Right, RT's Paul Clear reporting live. from Tripoli via Skype for us. Paula, thanks for that.